Welcome back to Chuck's Garage and our LS engine swap on a budget. Last time, Chuck installed the accessory drive system, and today for part 5, we tackled the exhaust system.
Hi, welcome back to Chuck's Garage. You know, it's been a long time since the last time I saw you, but we've been busy. It's been a busy summer for us. We've been going to car shows and working on other projects here. Plus, we've also been sizing out all the stuff that we need to complete our LS engine swap and move it forward here. Now, what we're going to be working on today is the exhaust system. Since we're using the Hooker motor mounts there, rather than using the Hooker headers, we've decided to use the cast iron manifolds here. Now, these are a pretty new design, but I want you to check these out. We're not going to be making a ton of horsepower here, so the cast iron manifolds are going to be perfectly adequate for what we're trying to do. And you can see they're a pretty free-flowing design. They're made out of heavy cast iron, and what I really like about them is they're going to package nicely inside the confines of the chassis. They're going to give us the flow that we need, and they're going to look good for a long time to come. Now, what I had to do to make these work was I had a set of head pipes made up at the local muffler shop here. It's just about an 18-inch piece of pipe here with a 60-degree bend. That gets the pipes tucked underneath the chassis and the crossmember there like we need. And what I'm going to do right now is I'm just kind of dumbing them up into place here so we can get these bolted to the engine. Then we'll work on the rest of the exhaust. But before we do that, I want to tell you something about these gaskets here. Now, these are GM gaskets. You got to use them between the head pipe and the manifold there. Now, these are an expensive one-time use only gasket. So we're going to hold off on bolting these up until we get the whole exhaust system in place, and then we can put everything all together and we can use them. I don't like buying these things. They're pretty expensive and one-time shot like that. Well, I think I can spend my money in other places better. Let's bolt these up and see what happens. These cast iron manifolds are going to bolt right up to these heads. They take the old bolts that we used off the old manifolds. They're the perfect length. But as you can see, we've got plenty of clearance here. They tuck in real nice. It'll give us plenty of clearance around our starter. And this head pipe that we had the muffler shop bend shoots it right back through the cross member area, just like we needed. Now, what we did with these head pipes is we've gone ahead and welded them all the way around to this head pipe flange that's included with the manifolds. And then that little gasket I showed you earlier, this thing comes from a fifth generation Camaro, so you'll know what to order, but you can see it just sits right there. It goes right in that receiver groove, and when it smashes down, this is a one-time use only, but it's going to give us the seal that we need. All right, now once you get the manifold bolted up, don't forget to reinstall your dipstick. And once we get this bolted up, we'll go take a look at our X-pipe setup that we're going to be using from Flowtech. Well, all right, now this is the Flowtech X-pipe setup that we're going to be using. Now, as you can see, they come with several bent pipes. They're all mandrel bent, so you don't squeeze them down. Good flow characteristics that way. And of course, this is the little X-pipe that's going to make it all work. Now, the first step that we've got to do is we're going to have to make these 45s up with our head pipes there and get them into this X-pipe situation. So we'll go ahead and start marking pipes so we can cut them. Now, the first thing that we want to do is establish the location of our X-pipe connector here, and we're going to position it right here where the end of the drive shaft is going to go into the transmission. And then what that's going to do is give the drive shaft plenty of room to articulate as the rear end moves up and down, and we won't get into any interference there. Now, once we've got that established, that looks pretty good right there, we're going to take one of the extensions and we're going to mark it. It slips into there, into that end. And we'll mark it up on this end where to cut it. And then once we get this thing cut right here, we'll take an expansion tube and we'll expand that out so it'll slip right over this head pipe here. I think we'll be in pretty good shape. We'll do the same thing on this side here, and we're ready to start making some cuts. Thank you. Now we're going to use a chop saw. It's going to make a nice, clean, quick cut, and we'll get this project underway. Now what we're going to do is get rid of all these ugly, rough, and dangerous edges here. These things will cut you quick. There we go. And then we can go ahead and expand it and slip it onto our head pipe. Now we just insert the tool like that, snug it up, and we just start opening it up with this ratchet. There we go. Looks good. Well, this is what our completed X-pipe setup looks like. Now, basically what we've done is we've gone ahead and made all of our cuts. We expanded the ends where we needed to, and we welded everything together. This is the muffler end. This is the head pipe end. Now, hopefully everything has stayed in place and it'll fit like it should. Oh yeah. Now that looks good. The X-pipe is right where we want it to be. The mufflers will go on here next. And speaking of that, let me show you what we're going to be using for mufflers. Now, before I show you those mufflers, I want to mention one quick thing here. Now, I've got the luxury of a welder here. You guys may not all have a welder at your disposal there. So Flowtech has gone ahead and they include all the clamps and gasket, flange plates and everything that you need to clamp this whole system together. But since we've got the welder, that's what we're gonna do. We'll repurpose these down the road. All right, now we're staying with Flowtech for our mufflers too, and we're using their afterburner mufflers. Now, basically what this is a turbo-style muffler with a fully welded aluminized case, plus they've been painted for extra corrosion resistance. Now, unlike some of the other mufflers that have the baffles inside them to quiet the sound, what these use is actually a perforated tube and packing to give us that real good muscular sound. Now, they're a double-double offset, just like any Chevelle muffler. I'm ready to slip them in place. Well, with one of them in place, all we gotta do is slip this other one on here, like that. That's looking really good. Now, we're about ready for the tailpipes. Wait till you see what I got planned for that. Now, what I've done here is I've had an old set of tailpipes that I had on another Chevelle here, and I've gone ahead and added this extra piece of pipe that came with the Flowtech kit. Now what that's gonna do is it's gonna extend this tailpipe into the end of the muffler there. I wasn't real sure what I'd do with these tailpipes when I cut them off the old car, so I did cut them a little bit short. But like I say, nothing that this extension won't take care of. And the hangers are already in place. We're about ready to bolt this thing up. Now what we're going to use here is a hanger, pretty much in the stock original location. It mounts up here to the frame like that. And I like to use these serrated nuts on here. Get that thing started. We'll tighten things up a little bit here. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. Go ahead and snug everything up real good. Do the same on the other side there. And then we'll go back to work on the tailpipe hangers. All right. Well, that pretty much cinches everything down. We got the exhaust system hung real well. The next thing we got to do is get that thing up on my lift over there, and I'll weld the whole system up complete. But in the meantime, I'll tell you what, so that we don't lose our settings or anything while we're moving this thing around over to the lift, I'm going to use some of those clamps that I showed you earlier just to kind of snug things down, keep things from moving around. All right, now that cinches down the exhaust system. I use a little torpedo to make sure that we're level front to back and even side to side. And these clamps are going to hold everything in place until we can get it over on the rack and get everything welded up. So that takes care of the exhaust system for today. But you'll want to be sure to join us again in a week or two. Then we're going to talk about the cooling system. Now I've got a lot of great hardware that's going to keep that LS engine cool, along with the transmission and even the power steering. So come back and see me in a couple of weeks.